Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Miami Mike Show. And here's your host, Miami Mike.
Game on, that's right. It's always game on at Miami Mike's. But anyway, welcome to the show. It was a great day here at Miami Mike's yesterday. And in the NFL, it's exciting to be back. We had a lot of ceremonies for 9/11 throughout the NFL. And it was very emotional yesterday. And I know some teams were held a little more under pressure, like the Redskins and the Giants, due to the attacks on those properties. But yesterday, I have to say that the Giants, they started okay, but their offense is anemic. And I think Giant fans, you have a long way to go this year before you take care of business. So let's talk a little bit about the Jets-Cowboy game last night. Because I know a lot of us Dolphin fans were watching that game, okay, and realized that Tony Romo cannot handle the pressure. I've come to the conclusion that he cannot win a big game, and at this time, I think that's the problem here with the Cowboys. They can move up and down, but when push comes to shove, they're not getting it done. He's a two-time national champion at Alabama. He played five seasons with the New York Giants and won a Super Bowl with the New York Giants. He played with Harry Carson and Lawrence Taylor, with some of those great defensive people, okay? Let's welcome to our show tonight, New York Giant and Alabama, Curtis McGriff. Welcome, Curtis, to the show here at Miami Mike's, huh? What a great place, huh? Awkward Orange. Look at the color out there. It looks good, right?
Yeah, looks good. Looks good. Looks good.
1978, 79, two-time champion with the Bryant.
Right.
Now, let me ask you. You know, I was a lot younger during those days with Bear Bryant as a coach. Tell us a little bit about him. How was he as a person? How was he like on the chalkboard? What was it like playing for such a legendary coach?
Well, you know, Coach Bryant was one of the legendary coaches, and he was more of a great coach, but then he was a great leader of a person. That when you came out of the University of Alabama as a player, whatever you do in life, you're never going to quit.
Correct.
Because our practices and the way he handled things, I mean, football was, you know, if you did great in football, you're going to do great in life. All right, and the guys that who stood there and took the, not the abuse, but what it takes to get it done. Sacrifice, discipline, and hard work. That's what he preached.
So basically, he preached it all, but he was a hard-nosed coach. If you could get through with Bear Bryant, you could get through with life.
There you go.
And that's a great way, because he was legendary. I wonder what he'd be thinking about now with Joe Paterno still coaching. Imagine that.
Yeah.
Joey Paterno all these years, and I'll never forget that goal line stand against Penn State, and there was Bear Bryant on one side and Joe Powell on the other side, and I know that Bear Bryant, that had to come, that was personal, him and legendary Joe Powell battling 1978, goal line, tell me about the four plays, they tried to stick it in there all four times, no? They didn't throw one play, they tried to pound it on you, and you were right in the middle there, you were the D-tackle, the defensive end that got it done.
Yeah.
And Don McNeil, the former Dolphin, the quarterback, he was a great Alabama player. Okay, Don McNeil.
I tell you what, Max, you brought that up. Don McNeil's my roommate in Alabama.
He's the roommate. Years. Dolphin fans, Don McNeil, former Dolphin, the roommate.
Yeah. And all had to do was run, running back from Penn State had to run outside. But he wanted to go for the power. And McNeil started that whole play. It wouldn't have been a fourth, you know, it wouldn't have been that fourth down run if the guy would have went inside. But went for the power, Mac caught him, and that's where it went.
Excellent. Good job. Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about your NFL career. You were an undrafted free agent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you signed with the Giants.
Mm-hmm.
How about your transition coming from like Alabama to New York at a young age? You were, I think, 22 when you came to the Giants. How was it coming to New York, being 22 on your own, and making that transition?
You know, coming from the University of Alabama, very, very strict environment, playing under Coach Bryant, then you come into nine the pros. I have no idea the pros what it was. I thought pros was when you come to the pro, you go out and practice for an hour and a half, and you watch soap opera. I was a big soap opera fan.
All right.
When I got to the pros, and I'm seeing Harry, I'm seeing George, and these guys all But in practice, when pro football was a job. Right? And a serious job, and you're practicing twice a day. I've been practicing, you know, once a day, and now with the guy in the pros, you know, it's a 24-hour, you know, you're practicing twice a day in 3-4 hour practices. I knew it happened like that.
Well, you know, now with the new contract, they can only practice once a day.
Yeah.
Back in the day, all you did was practice, watch.
Oh, I wish I was back then now.
Back then was so much harder than it is today.
Yeah.
You agree with that?
Oh, yeah. No doubt about it. No doubt about it.
Let's talk about Coach Parcells a little bit.
Yeah.
All right, because he is another legendary coach. He's been around the league a lot now, but you are one of two players to play under the two legendary coaches. Tell us how Bill Parcells was coaching also. I don't want to compare him to Bear Bryant because they're totally different, but how was it under Parcells? They say he's a hard knock.
Yeah. You know what? The comparison I see between Coach Bryant, you know, and Bill, like I said, you can't compare these two coaches, but their coaching style. They knew what player needed what. And that was the key to any great coach, I think. If a coach knows what player needed to be bumped along a little bit or a little scored out a little bit, and one player needed to be just let him play. And those guys' style was, I mean, very resemblance.
Very similar. How about, let's talk about a little bit about who I believe is the best defensive player in the history of the NFL, Lawrence Taylor.
Yeah.
Because when you were a rookie, you came up. What was it like meeting him for the first time? What was it in the locker room, watching him play on the field? Because you were also this, you were a starting defensive end. Mm-hmm. You were the left defensive end.
Mm-hmm.
You had.
Yeah. He was unbelievable.
Right on their side.
He was unbelievable. You know, Adam played with and with some great ones. The Dwight Stevenson, your center for the Dolphins.
That's correct.
Hall of Famer. Played with. But this guy here was unbelievable. I mean, I never saw a player that did the things he did. And the one thing that he did, and I do a lot of camps talking to different kids and stuff like this, to make a great ball player, he had this thing that the average ball player don't have. He went 110% for the whole 60 minutes.
All the time.
That doesn't exist because most players gonna take a playoff.
Correct.
He did not take a playoff for 60 minutes.
No, believe me, you don't have to tell me. I watched him all the time. That guy was flying all over the place. I mean, I actually, during the early 80s, okay?
Yeah.
80 to 84, 80 to 86. It was a bit, I was not here yet at Miami Mikes. So I spent a lot of time home with my family. We used to watch all those great Giant games, those battles against the 49ers, and all those great games. And I tell you what, those Giant games were phenomenal. And, you know, watching Harry Carson, Gary Reasons, you know, and people like that brought back a lot of good memories here, you know, with Giants football. How about your Super Bowl experience, you know?
You know what? The Super Bowl was great. When I got here with the Giants in 80, all right, I'm coming from a program, just had two national championships. I didn't know what losing was.
Right.
My rookie year, we were 3-13.
Your rookie year.
Yeah, and then they bring in, the 81 season, they bring in Lawrence, you know. And people ask me all the time, how was the Super Bowl run? It was like I enjoyed the scene coming from developing a winner. Developing it.
Right, because when you were there, you guys were at the lower end.
With lower end of
NFL. 3-13, probably the 30th pick out of 32 teams, if not the last pick. And then all of a sudden, you bring in a defensive end from North Carolina. Next thing you know, oh my God, you're 14-2, 13-3. You're battling for the championships every year, in and year out. Yeah. And I tell you, I have a lot of great fond memories. And I think that, you know, one thing I do know is that you do have one fumble recovery.
Mm-hmm.
All right, do you remember it? You had 3 yards.
St. Louis.
He recovered.
St. Louis.
3 yard recovery, no?
Stump Mitchell hit him. All right, the ball bounced up. No, I was hitting my Harry hit him.
Harry caught
the balls came up, and I caught it to the Robinson. Yeah. And I was on my way to the end zone, and I'm seeing the lights. Then he bring me down.
He brought you down. Good stuff there. That's great. I tell you what. I tell you. And what about the current? What do you think about the current job? Did you watch the game yesterday, the Giant Redskin game?
Yeah.
Did you have a chance to see any of it?
Yeah.
What do you think about this current team right now?
Well, you know what? First of all, it's typical Giants Redskins game. It's always gonna be hard nose. You never know what's gonna happen. You know. And those were the Redskins and the Eagles was when I was playing there my 7 years with the Giants. Right. That was all. Those was the one that you know. Strap it on, it's going to be a dogfight.
Strap it up in the trenches.
And it was a dogfight like it was.
Unbelievable. Well, once again, ladies and gentlemen, let's thank our guests here tonight, New York Giants, Alabama, Curtis McGriff with us tonight. So we're going to answer some questions from our great fans here at Miami Mike's that come here all the time. This is from RJ, Rob, and Brian from Livingston. How many teams in the NFL have two Hall of Fame quarterbacks? Good question. Where's Rob at? Do you know the answer? Two. Two for me and two for you. Dan. What are the Patriots going to win tonight? Why are the Patriots going to win tonight? If the Patriots win tonight, it's because Tom Brady is going to dissect the Dolphin defense, and the Dolphins offensive line is not going to protect Chan Henne. That's if the Patriots win tonight. Earl from Short Hills. What should be the Dolphins' first offensive play tonight? Well, I would like to do a play-action post pattern for a touchdown so I can play the Dolphins' fight song and we can get this season off to a bang. Yeah, yeah. Pablo from Hawthorne. The Hammer. How do the Dolphins stop New England's double tight end set? Well, I'll tell you what, I don't think anybody can really stop the double tight end set. It's just a matter of trying to get a pass rush on Brady, putting pressure on him. They're going to be able to throw the ball if we don't have pressure, whether it's to the tight ends or the running backs. Either way, the Dolphins need to get pressure to control this game. All right, and our final question for Ask Miami Mike segment as we get ready for our Monday night doubleheader is from Ronnie from Bluefield, New Jersey. Is Chad Henne capable of making the big throw? My answer to that is yes. I believe Chad Henne this year is going to make the big throws with this new offense, and I expect Chad Henne to have a very good season, not like last year when the team looked very confused. Chad Henne is the Dolphins quarterback this year, and he is the Dolphins quarterback of the future. So, yes, Chad Henne and the Dolphins are going to get it done.
Step on the scene, y'all know me, 'cause I walk with a limp like a old school pimp, a real OG. I'm rocking bands, I'm in the sand, I got a Red Bull and vodka up in my hand. Hey, you look kinda cute, hey, in that polka dot bikini, girl. Hey, this what I wanna do. Take off that polka dot bikini, girl.
Drink all day, play all night. Let's get